Band of Defenders. Is it worth a buy? Is it, guys? Is it? Let's read the words of the developer, and then I'll tell you what I think. A co-op first-person game with base building in a post-apocalyptic world. Craft weapons, build barricades and automated turrets, unlock new gear and items for visual customization, and kill all savages and mutants trying to destroy the remnants of human civilization.
First off, guys, I want to thank the developer who gave me 4 keys for this game. There were press copy keys, so I had access to the game before that it was actually released. It still isn't out yet. It comes out tomorrow. But I was able to bring myself in and 3 patrons, and we had 4 players, so we could do the 4-player co-op, because I wanted to test this in single player, 2-player and 4-player, and I have done that, and in 3-player I've tested it as well. So it is quite versatile. It's a good idea for people defending an area of a map against waves of enemies by building towers and barricades and upgrading their own gear, getting better weapons, sniper rifles, machine guns, traps, grenades, all that kind of stuff. On paper, sounds great, but in reality, guys, it's just not great. That's the problem with it. So let's start by seeing what you actually do. The map center will have something you have to defend. It might be a spaceship or whatever. It just seems like a random thing in there. The enemy will go for that and they will start hitting it. You can't maze the enemy either. We haven't been able to maze them at all. They just run straight for the turrets and try and take the turrets out. I think it might be a damage thing. Whatever damages them, that's what they go for. Now, the way the gameplay works is you start off on wave 1 and the wave just comes at you and you have to shoot it with your pistol. That's all you've got, a pistol and a knife, I think you have. And then as soon as that wave's defeated, you go into build mode, which lasts about 30 seconds. You have a set amount of funds that you can buy stuff with. This stuff could be walls, turrets, new machine guns, traps, grenades, all kinds of stuff for either defending the map or defending yourself. And there's the first problem with the game, because 30 seconds is not enough time to coordinate with your teammates. Your teammates may have access to different stuff that you have. It all depends on their level and what random stuff that they've unlocked. For example, I have a machine gun nest, but one of my buddies has this spiky wall trap, which when the enemy hits it, they take damage. Some of them have different turrets to me. It's all different, so we can't coordinate what we're going to do because we don't have time. After 30 seconds, building ceases and the next wave's India straight away. And then after you get rid of that wave, and the waves get progressively harder, as you would imagine, the building phase happens again, and you're running around trying to repair stuff in that building phase, building yourself. You've got to get yourself stuff like new weapons. You can't have a pistol all the time. You've got to build machine guns, sniper rifles, grenades, traps and stuff. And all that time, you're trying to build a wall around the freaking base, which you don't have time to do. You don't even know what your colleagues is doing. You're so frantically doing your own thing. So you maybe throw a couple of towers down, and then you realize your friends have put towers down there as well. And before you know it, the building phase is over and the next wave's on its way to you. And that's the way the game is all the way. Now, I get that they want that for franticness. They want that to get it a bit frantic, but it ruins the gameplay. It would be far more enjoyable if after the wave ended, we think, right, this next wave's going to be tough. What you got? Right, I've got this tower, you've got that tower, you've got that kind of wall. Well, let's put your wall around about here, surround my tower with that, and we'll put another one there, and we, you know, 5 minutes to plan. 5 minutes to plan would have been great. Then you all press ready, next wave comes. That would be enjoyable. This isn't enjoyable, because at the end of the day, by wave 7 and 8, your base is just a big fucking mess of broken walls, a couple of turrets here and there, some spiky walls there, some non-spiky walls here. Everybody's just crafting a shitload of first aid kits, grenades, guns and stuff, and it's all just a mess. You don't know what's repaired, what isn't repaired. Everybody's running around like crazy. Then someone will say, oh, there's no defenses left on the east side. Oh, too late, the next wave's coming. You only have time to look at maybe one or two sides of it as you're going, and you're relying on your teammates to look at the other sides, but they might be looking at other sides as well. It's a big mess. But even when the fighting starts, the fighting's awful. The gunplay is horrible. I came from Far Cry 5 to this. The gunplay of Far Cry 5 is amazing. You know, that you feel like you're firing a gun into someone. And I know that's a AAA game and this is a small indie game, but you get no sense whatsoever of firing the weapons at people, that you're hitting them. It's all just the enemy doesn't even react to the bullets going in them. It's just, you just see a blood splash and that's it. It's awful. The melee combat's even worse. You're just like slashing away at a, like with a penknife at this giant guy who seems to be whacking these huge things at you and doing not much damage. It's just the combat and gameplay is awful. The turrets seem terrible as well. You have these all these lines of turrets and the enemy's just standing in front of them slashing away at them, and it's like, well, are you going to take any damage off that? Fair enough, these are only rank 1 turrets, but we haven't got to rank 2 yet because the grind in this game is even worse than the other two things I've mentioned. Oh my goodness, the grind. I've played this for 4 solid hours, guys. It doesn't seem a lot, 4 hours, but believe you me, when you're on the same f***ing 2 or 3 maps, just building endless walls and machine gun nests and having the same enemies run at you, it feels like torture. It feels like a torture. It doesn't feel like you're having fun in a game. There is just hardly any kind of carrot and stick grind to this game. I mean, I grinded a whole 2 levels of this, which took half an hour. All I got was a fucking nurse's outfit in a gimp mask. Sorry, not a gimp mask. It was one of them masks that I would wear to a swingers party. No, sorry, that some people wear. I don't know. And I'm a male, so I wouldn't wear either of them things, but that's all I got. That's it. I've got the same gun that I had when I first installed the game. I've got the same turrets I had when I first installed the game. I've got the same wall that I had when I first installed the game. All I've got to show for 4 hours of grinding these boring levels over and over again is a gimp mask, a nurse's outfit, a coin that gives me 2,000 extra credits at the beginning of each round, and a bear trap. That's it. That's it. Now, does that give you any incentive to want to play for another 4 hours? Of course it fucking doesn't. There should be about 20 different types of towers. By now I should at least have 4 towers. I don't. I've still got the same f***ing 2. How many guns do I have? I've got the same f***ing guns that I had as well. I'm sick of firing the same gun at the same enemy for hours. It's just, no. I'm sorry, but you need to fix this game. It needs severely fixing. It needs way more enemies, way more gun types, way more generosity in handing out the stuff in the grind, or people are going to refund it. It's got to be fun. Games, first and foremost, have to be fun. The fact that you've wanted to make this game with a big grind and all that, it sounds great on paper, but if the implementation is not done in a fun way, people aren't going to play it, and this isn't fun. Nobody enjoyed it that played it with us. It was like you could tell it was a chore for them. And that's sad, because it is a good idea, this. It's just not implemented the best way that it could have. It's just not fun enough. It's missing out on the huge amount of fun that this game could be. So I'm going to thumb this down, guys. It needs a lot of work before it becomes a fun game.